Sherry. Good morning, everyone. I am Dan Miller. I am the state representative in the 42nd district. I'm very thankful to be in front of you here this morning with so many of my friends to talk about adult changing tables. We're glad to have a good program here that's going to give you some ideas of what we have in the House and the Senate, but also give you information as to why these bills are important. And I do think it is important to note, just last month, of course, or just about, we had celebrated the 29th anniversary of the Americans with Disabilities Act. Obviously a tremendous bill that has been a game changer for many in this country, probably arguably the second or third most important civil rights bill our country's ever passed. And that's tremendous. But the Americans with Disabilities Act didn't solve everything. It wasn't meant to solve everything, that's true, but it hasn't solved everything, and this is why we got to continue the fight both at the state and at the federal level and the local level to be sure that we are opening doors of opportunities for people to enjoy our world, to participate in our economy, and to live as independent as possible in the process. Well, that becomes problematic if you're missing out key ingredients of what it is that life demands. And obviously for us with adult changing tables, this is an important issue to which if these facilities are not addressed, then we are essentially telling a large portion of this country that they will have to have a limited exposure, limited experiences, limited opportunities to enjoy a life. And as we have advanced and as we have gone through so much to open up doors of opportunities for people with disabilities, at this time, in this age, it is just not acceptable for us not to open up these doors of opportunities. And to help me to understand this issue, help me explain this issue with you, I'm very excited to bring up our first speaker, Ms. Christina Abernathy. Christina was and is a parent advocate. She is the person who first came to me, and I know has gone to all the senators to speak about this issue personally. She's been a fantastic advocate locally as well as nationally with trying to bring attention to this issue, and I'm very glad that she's here today to share her story. Christina?
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Christina Abernathy, and I reside in Allegheny County with my husband and my three children. I serve as the Family Support and Community Engagement Specialist at Achieving True Self, supporting families just like mine. I'm the founder of Love, Hope, and Autism, where I share a family's journey. I have also been appointed as the coordinator of Changing Spaces Pennsylvania. Our mission at Changing Spaces is to promote community, inclusion, access, and equality for individuals with disabilities nationwide who cannot safely utilize standard restrooms independently. I'd like to introduce to you my son, Ethan, also known as Bubba. Our Bubba is one of the sweetest boys you will ever meet. He has a smile that can light up the darkest of days and a laugh that is truly contagious. Bubba loves animals, and so we like to take trips to the zoo and more recently a petting zoo. He also enjoys playing at the park with his twin brother, Braden, and his neighborhood friends. We attend sensory-friendly events at local theaters and museums to allow him a safe space to truly be himself and enjoy these experiences without judgment. Ethan has autism and other medical diagnoses that require the assistance of others. I think it goes without saying that the phrase, "it truly takes a village," resonates with families like ours. At this time, I invite you to close your eyes and picture this. It's a hot summer day, and we're enjoying time as a family at our local zoo. Ethan has had an accident and needs help getting clean and changed as quickly as possible. We leave the rest of our family in the zoo enjoying the exhibits, and I am walking him all the way back to our car. I'm now lifting my 85-pound son in 90-degree weather into the back of our SUV and lay him down. People are walking by, watching us, staring, pointing, making rude remarks, but I continue to clean him and try to hurry to not expose him for too long. Open your eyes. So you might be thinking that's not that big of a deal, Christina. I changed my child in the back of the car too when they were little. But my child is 8 years old and 85 pounds. Was yours? Or in my friend Kathy's situation, as you will hear more in a few moments, it would have been her 65-year-old father and 230 pounds. Let's take this another step further. If our car is parked too far away, we locate the nearest restroom. Now picture a dirty public restroom floor that leaves most people wondering, what is that? Or I don't even want to know on the restroom floor. When looking down, picture me placing a beach towel on the floor and then laying my son to change him. me on my knees changing my son on a public restroom floor because there are no adult-sized changing tables available. Sure, there might be a baby changing table, but he grew out those tables 5 years ago. The weight limit on those are 35 to 40 pounds and truly only accessible for infants and small toddlers. After years of changing in public parking lots and laying him on the dirty restroom floor, I decided enough was enough. I started sharing our story on my Love, Hope, and Autism Facebook page and creating different posts and videos about why powered height-adjustable adult-sized changing tables are so important. I was talking to Kathy and I said, there has to be more that I can do. I know there are families out there struggling with this same issue. She opened up and shared her story of caregiving with me, completely different, yet so much the same. She encouraged me to create a petition sharing our story and the need for adult-sized changing tables in private family restrooms. The petition currently has over 16,000 signatures on it and still growing. A local news station saw my story on Facebook and offered to interview me about this issue to educate our community. Our story was shared nationally and people from all over our country began reaching out to me. I was contacted by a group of parents that are part of a nationwide campaign called Changing Spaces. It was truly eye-opening to hear their stories and the struggles they face on a daily basis because of the lack of accessible restrooms. It was from that point on, I knew that this was bigger than me. It's bigger than my Bubba and truly a nationwide issue. So what's next? That's when I approached Representative Dan Miller and asked him what we could do to make change. He was extremely supportive and listened to my concerns. We talked and discussed different ideas, and over the next few months, he created and introduced HB 117. This bill is designed to create inclusive and accessible restrooms in places of large capacity, like sports arenas, airports, hospitals, museums, highway rest stops, and more. This will not affect small businesses, your favorite mom-and-pop restaurant down the street, or the local gas station. Not long after HB 117 was introduced, I met with Senator Bartolotta and Senator Iovino's staff, and they decided to create a companion bill. The Senate memo was released this past week. So why go through all of this trouble to have a changing table big enough for my son? Because this is not just about my son. This is for the very large population of people that are so often forgotten. This is for our disabled veterans, our elderly loved ones, our family member that uses a wheelchair, the neighbor down the street who suffered a stroke, your mother living with MS, your father with dementia, your brother with cerebral palsy, your daughter with epilepsy, or your son with autism. Disabilities and chronic medical conditions affect thousands of families, not only in our state, but across our entire nation. Everyone deserves privacy and human dignity. We all have different stories and different walks of life. We have different diagnoses and valid reasons why we need powered, height-adjustable, adult-sized changing tables available at large community places. But the commonality is that this one piece of equipment will be life-changing and create a dignified and accessible space for all. It's time we stop splitting up families during community outings. It's time we stop using our cars as a public restroom. It's time we stop laying our loved ones on dirty bathroom floors. It's time we respect everyone's privacy. Human dignity is not an option. It's time for change.
Thank you, Christina. And you could see how impactful her words are and her story is once you pause for a moment and listen to what it means to go day by day and have this challenge. Next up, I'm very proud to introduce my senator, who I know also cares so much about the disability community, Senator Pam Iovino.
Thank you, everybody. I am more than pleased to join this event today. So thank you to Senator Dan Miller. Thank you to Christina for that very candid and eloquent personal story that she just shared with all of us. And that's all it took was my hearing of that story to say, I want on board to help make be part of this public advocacy and make a change here. As Dan mentioned, 29 years ago, Americans with Disability Act was passed. It's a watershed moment, but it was not the panacea to fix everything. And so we have this brave mother, fierce mama bear, going out and further shedding a light on something of it's just a simple reality of do you grit your teeth and this decision that you're faced with. You grit your teeth and decide that you're going to be able to have these public outings with your family, these normal everyday things that families do. But the flip side of it is this potential lack of privacy, lack of hygiene to care for one of your loved ones, to care for one of your family members. And this and what she's further educated us all about is the breadth of who is potentially impacted by this, our elderly, those with other medical issues, our disabled veterans, that this is a much larger population in this hidden situation with a really simple solution to it. These powered, adjustable, can be accommodated in already existing the private family restrooms that are in facilities. So I was on board immediately to be able to do this. I am very pleased to join a SEDD colleague who, long before I ever arrived here, she's been on board being a fierce supporter and advocate for those with disabilities, and that is Senator Bartolotta, who I'm going to turn the podium over to now, but happy to join all of you here today and looking forward to you're all hearing Kathy's story as well. Very important. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you. And as Senator Iovino mentioned, I've always, I tell you what, Senator Bartolotta has been fantastic with disability issues. She's worked with me on several items, disability, mental health. I notice she always comes out for our Disability Mental Health Summit and brings a lot of personal interest, personal stories, and energy to the discussions every time. So we're very glad to, again, have Senator Bartolotta here with us today.
Thank you, Representative. In 1981, I was in a near-fatal car accident driving home from college. And because of that accident, I spent almost a year in a wheelchair. Now, again, this was in 81. This was pre-ADA, and believe me, trying to get to my, thank God for my mom. We had an electric wheelchair she would take out of the trunk, and I would get into it, and I would attend my classes trying to catch up at a community college with curbs, with doors you can't open, and it really, really drives the point home for me in my district, helping all those individuals who are trying desperately to participate in activities that we take for granted every single day. Any way that we can help those individuals, and as you are aware too, you know, buses and public transportation and public facilities, we're really focusing on making life a lot easier for folks with disabilities to get around, to go to work, to go shopping, to get to. But we have been leaving out the most basic fundamental human need, and that's just the ability to use a restroom. We want families to bring their loved ones out. We want families to have the ability to access all of these phenomenal things that are part of our daily activities with our other children, with our other family members. But when you think about what it's like for a parent to take their very large, growing, you know, sometimes adult autistic child and lay them on a filthy, nasty public bathroom floor. I know people, if you drop a dollar, you're not gonna pick it up, right? Yeah, imagine placing your child in a situation like that. And I noticed when she was reading off the list of other individuals with needs that this will accommodate, the room got really quiet. Your mom with a stroke, your sister with epilepsy, or any of those conditions, you start thinking, wow, that could be me one day. Last month, I was able to go to the Pittsburgh International Airport and see their phenomenal facility. I wish I could. What's the name of the sensory room at the Pittsburgh International Airport? Sorry? Presley's Place. Thank you so much. Phenomenal, phenomenal space for individuals who need a safe place to go, calm and quiet, and all these other things that they can do to shut out the noise, the hustle and the bustle. And Pittsburgh International Airport has installed an adult changing table. I can't even imagine the lives that has changed. and to accommodate the needs, again, the most basic fundamental human needs for individuals, for families, to keep families together who want to be out there to enjoy these things. It's just incredible. I have, my nephew has four children. Two are severely autistic, nonverbal autistic, but at least they're mobile and can use facilities and things. But I can't imagine how needing something like this would compound all of the other issues that are presented with families that are attending to the needs of these incredible children for a lifetime. So I'm thrilled to be a co-sponsor of this. I am thrilled to be able to really shine a light on the needs that are out there for a large population. I'm chair of the Labor and Industry Committee, and we will be having a hearing on this, and we will be shedding even more light on it. And it's just incredible the lives that we are going to change when we finally get this across the finish line. So thank you all for being here, and I look forward to having a hearing and talking a lot more about this issue.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you for also bringing it up in your committee. Fantastic. Appreciate that. I recognize my voice is in and out a little bit today. But voices are important. And one of the key voices when it comes to disability advocacy in Pennsylvania is our good friends over at the ARC of PA. And they have obviously been around for decades, leading the fight on a variety of issues to expand opportunities and independence for people with disabilities in Pennsylvania. And that's why we're very glad today to have the Executive Director, Sherry Landis, here from the ARC to talk to us.
Thank you. Thank you, Representative Miller. Senators, thank you as well for inviting me here today to speak in support of House Bill 117, and now the Senate bill, which we will be excited to work with you as well. For the past 69 years, the ARC of Pennsylvania and its 33 chapters has been the state's leading advocate for individuals with intellectual and developmental disabilities and their families. Our members and chapters represent people of all ages, many types of disabilities, including but not limited to autism, Down syndrome, people with complex medical and behavioral needs. It is the ARC of Pennsylvania's mission to ensure that children and adults with intellectual and developmental disabilities receive the support and services they need, are included in their community, and have control over their own lives. Accessibility is one of the greatest hurdles facing the disability community. When the topic of accessibility is discussed, people often think of sidewalks or ramps, or door openers to building entrances. What is always overlooked is accessible restroom facilities that include adult changing tables. All families love to go on vacation, whether it is a trip to the state capitol or a drive on the Pennsylvania Turnpike to go to the beach. And if you've ever traveled with children or some adults, everyone knows that there are stops along the way for a restroom break. But for families traveling with a loved one who needs a private room to take care of their personal needs, a trip to the beach or the state capitol are never taken. Today, families are forced to change their loved ones on the floor of a public restroom because public buildings are not required to provide accessible changing table facilities. Individuals with disabilities and families are restricted from going to many of the popular tourist locations, which those without a disability readily access. House Bill 117 is a common sense bill that addresses these issues facing the disability community by requiring state-owned buildings and certain places of public accommodation, including auditoriums, convention centers, sports arenas, and amusement parks, to install and maintain at least one adult changing station. Adult changing facilities reduce the risk of injury to caregivers and allows individuals who require assistance to receive it in a space that is hygienic and allows for their privacy and dignity to be respected. It also enables those with disabilities to participate within their own community and build their independence. Thank you, Representative Miller, and all the co-sponsors of House Bill 117, and the senators in taking the initiative to allow families and individuals access our amazing Commonwealth and all that it has to offer.
Thank you. Thank you so much. We definitely appreciate your words. And we could use some more co-sponsors. There's never enough. So more co-sponsors on the House or Senate version would be great as well. And our final speaker today is another parent advocate, not just a parent, a daughter advocate in some ways too, right, who's going to give us a little more insight as to how this bill and these bills can assist with parents as they grow older as too. So we're very glad to have Kathy Hughes here. Kathy, come on up.
Such powerful testimony. Thank you so much, everybody. Good afternoon. My name is Catherine Hughes. I'm from Allegheny County. During the day, my role is Director of Family Support and Community Engagement with Achieving True Self, supporting families across multiple states, including Pennsylvania. I am an author, blogger, speaker, trainer, and advocate for multiple causes, proudly including Changing Spaces, Pennsylvania. Most importantly, I am a mother and I am a daughter. Because of two very diverse yet parallel experiences lived within both roles, comprised with family stories from those I am so fortunate to support, I am proud to serve alongside Representative Miller and Senators Bartolotta and Iovino, and my best friend Christina Abernathy, to champion this legislation and ensure that HB 117 and soon-to-be companion bill moves ahead swiftly and reaches the governor's desk as quickly as possible. Last weekend, my mother, son, and I went out to dinner as a family. We enjoyed our meal together, conversing and watching the Steeler game on the big screen. Unfortunately, we were losing. Before heading home, I went into the women's restroom, and there it was, right in front of me. I snapped a picture of the wall, shaking my head before continuing to use the bathroom. I felt a twinge of guilt washing over me. When I came back out of the stall, and I started thinking about people so close to my heart as I was just washing my hands. I recalled my conversation with Christina approximately 1 year ago as we discussed creating a petition that encourages large venues to install adult-sized changing tables in their restrooms. It saddened me as she shared yet another story about how her family was faced with a choice to either head home early from a family outing, exposing her son in the trunk of her car, or laying him on a cold, wet, filthy, germ-infested floor in order to have him changed and cleaned properly after an accident. These stories and calls from Christina were becoming more frequent, and as she knew something had to be done, upon creating her petition, sharing her story on a local news station, and then connecting with families across this nation, she and I discovered Changing Spaces Pennsylvania. The more I learned about this movement, the more thankful I was that there were men and women across this country determined to provide dignified space and equipment for those who cannot independently use the bathroom and need additional supports in place. My son, now 21, has a diagnosis on the autism spectrum. It was not until he was far past the weight limit for an infant changing table, just like the hard stationary platform I saw attached to the wall behind me at a restaurant, that he was able to effectively use the restroom. I too remembered the days when I needed to bring a towel or a large changing pad so I could lay Christian on the floor. I remember not wanting to put the towel back in our diaper bag because it was disgusting. It was soiled, it was sticky, it was wet with black water. But that towel protected him from lying in filth. In that moment, while I was washing my hands, I also thought about my father, and my eyes stung with tears. Can you imagine needing to change a 230-pound man swollen with water in such an area? Even with a longer table, trying to lift him onto one to be changed proves not only physically challenging, but very painful for him. My amazing father, who instilled in me a giving heart and the courage to stand up for others, passed away 10 years ago. In his final year of life, he resided in a senior living facility not far from our home, and prior to that was supported by an adult site-based day program. Before his illness, he was an active person who fulfilled an incredible social life, and I'm pretty sure at that time his was more active than mine. As his condition continued to deteriorate, this once lively man, completely confined to his bed and his wheelchair, was unable to now use the restroom with a walker. He sometimes required two-on-one support to be changed, especially depending on the size and stature of his aide. His ability to attend community outings with his roommate and fellow residents slowly faded to a memory as he was dying. Whether visiting a mall, a stadium, a theater, or a restaurant like the one whose restroom I used in that moment of reflection, there was nowhere for him to be changed after relieving himself. That meant he would have to sit in soiled, wet briefs during the remainder of that outing until returning to a premises where he could be cared for properly. Even if a table existed where he was visiting, lifting him often proved to be a challenge. I recognized in that very moment that the restroom I was standing within would not meet the requirements for a powered height adjustable changing table, nor would the venue qualify as a space that would fall under this mandate that we're all here fighting for today. But I thought to myself, what if? What if stadiums, airports, rest stops, auditoriums, and amusement parks, to name just a few facilities, installed these changing areas for people of all ages who demonstrate this critical need? What if we decided once and for all that bathroom floors are no longer an option? What if we recognize that everyone deserves a private and safe area to be changed and cleaned? We would be living in a state where individuals of all ages from 8 to 80, impacted by a wide scale of diagnoses or conditions, will have more opportunities to be included. We'll have the accommodations that they not only need, but they unquestionably deserve. In turn, large-scale facilities will experience an increase in patronization. This is a simple, universal win, as the investments made will return to us tenfold. Maybe then I won't feel as guilty about my ability to freely and effortlessly use a public restroom effectively. I will know that everyone is slowly but surely being granted the same opportunity as me. They won't have to go home or stretch out in the back of a car to gain privacy. They also won't need to lie on the ground. Human dignity can no longer be optional. Dignity is a demand that is beyond reasonable. We have no more time to waste. It's time. It's time for change.
Thank you, Kathy, and thank you to all our speakers. I do hope the senators will pause for a moment, too, in case we have some questions at the end. I also want to thank all the parents who came up today, as well as our professionals who came up from Pioneer School in Pittsburgh that cares almost entirely for people who would all benefit. Most of them would benefit from or need to have this law passed in order for them to be able to be out in the world to the degree that you would want to be out in the world. So thank you for making the trip up. Look, we've done this before. We've redefined what it is to have a restroom open to the public before. This is not new. This is not a new thing. Okay, we mentioned the ADA multiple times. We talked about it 29 years ago. And we know that it only, at the end of the day, got passed, really, because so many people with disabilities wouldn't accept anything else. And those champions, many of which, for the wheelchair community, discarded their wheelchair and crawled up the steps of the Capitol to emphasize what is needed to have full access to your government. That's the type of heroism that got that bill passed. And it's represented here today by our speakers who came here to talk about their loved ones, their families and their professions, and of course our great senators who care about these issues. We're going to get there. My hope is that we will get there this session in changing the way that bathrooms are defined as to what it means to allow everyone from all over Pennsylvania, full access to a public restroom in the facilities that we all otherwise take for granted. So thank you for your time. We will just see if we have any questions, and I'll invite the senators as well as everybody up in case they can help with any questions. Do we have any questions? So we have strong support. That would be great. Thank you for your time.